beautiful friends, and welcome back to my channel. This is Nova Gnome Creations, and I'm Nova, and I am so happy to see you today. I hope you and your loved ones are doing well, and I hope you are taking care of the best that you can. Hopefully you guys are all doing good and enjoying your summer. If you like the heat, hopefully you're out and having fun in your garden or playing in the pool or whatever it is that you like to get up to. And if you don't like the heat, hopefully you're nice and hunkered down in your AC, have your fan on, you know, doing something to cool down. And if you are in a part of the world that is not having summer right now, well, I hope you're having a good whatever season it is. And hopefully no inclement weather is getting in the way of your plans. So I wanted to hop on here today to share with you guys some crochet stuff. I haven't done a very like crochet video in a little bit, and I am overdue. So I have a couple things I want to show you guys today. Let's see. The first thing I'm going to start with, I had to pick between the two, is this month's hooker versus hooker thing. For July, they had the challenge to make a pillow. Like I've said before, for this particular month, I'm not part of hooker versus hooker, or I'm not a contestant. I'm just having, participating for the fun of it. So they had to make a pillow, and they had to use the colors. Let me get out my little handy dandy booklet here. I have this little Jawsom Valentine booklet that my good friend Amy sent me as part of a little Valentine's Day gift. And I like to write that stuff down in here. Okay, so they had to make a pillow for Hooker versus Hooker July, and they had to include white, black, teal, and peach as their color schemes. So if you guys haven't been around and seen like the way the hooker versus hooker works, basically they say what you gotta make, what the rules are regarding it. Like sometimes you can use things like buttons or whatever that aren't crochet, but other than that, it has to be yarn. And then as far as the colors go, you can pick any yarn that is in that color, but it has to be in that color. It can't be a variegated yarn. It can't be you using multiple yarns that are that color. It has to be one single yarn for each color, that color. Could be any size yarn, any brand yarn, whatever you've got. Okay. So I decided to do this challenge. There's like little hairs all over this. I haven't picked this up in like a week or so, and it's just been sitting over here, and honestly my cats have probably been laying on it. So I decided to join in on this one, and this is what I've got so far. I need to incorporate black still, but I'm not sure how I want to incorporate black yet. So I decided to make this little pillow. And what I did was I actually made this in the size of a small pillow that I already had. I have these little pillows that are like my favorite pillow to sleep with at night, and I got a new one. Actually, my mother-in-law gave it to me, and it was like exactly the type of pillow I use, so I was so happy. I was like, I actually really needed to replace it. But instead of just like getting rid of my old one, I decided to use it to stuff this pillow. So inside of here is actually a pillow. I'm like upcycling it, I guess. And it's like a little bit bigger than this, I think, but it kind of worked to fill it out nicely. Or at least, you know, maybe it wasn't quite this shape. So I had to fill it out nicely. So I did one side this color, and then I did the other side like this. And this is the closest I had to a peach yarn. I think it's more of a light pink, a pale pink, but I wasn't going to go buy yarn for this. This is just like what I have in my stash. So that is the closest I had to a peach yarn. I just made basically two granny squares, did like a solid granny type of style. And then for this one, I did it just to this round in the pink or the peach, and then I switched to the teal. And then I also made a little pocket on here, and that's what I incorporated my white with. I did like kind of lacy looking by using a skinnier white yarn, you know, with the little bit bigger hook. And then I sewed that. Well, I crocheted, I think I crocheted, yes, I crocheted this side on, and then this side I sewed down. So I attached this kind of after the fact. I made this white piece, and then I crocheted it on doing picot stitches. And then, like I said, I sewed it on down here. Kind of has like a lacy sort of cage kind of look to it. But the idea behind it is this little pocket is perfect for like your remote, your phone, candies, snacks, whatever that you're sitting with, you know, to keep it like nice and like with you. Or, you know, you can have nothing in it and it's just a pillow. But I thought that would be a cute little idea to have a little pocket pillow. I need to incorporate black into this still, but I'm not really sure what I want to do yet. Originally, I was thinking I was going to put little embellishments on the pillow in the black, but I might do a border. I might go like around the pillow and do a border. I'm not really sure yet. So let me know what you guys think, if you have any ideas of how I should incorporate the black into this pillow. But this is going to be my like hooker versus hooker, like not being part of it submission, you know, just doing it for funsies submission. And I think it came out cute and it's really soft. These are really soft yarns. I used, I know this was like a Premier Bulky yarn. I don't remember. I think I might have taken pictures. If I took pictures of the yarns, I will include those in here. But I know this one was like a Premier Bulky. I think it was anti-pilling. And then the other thing that I've been working on is not done, but I've been working on the beginnings of a top. So I am using the Cinnamon Stitches Spring Fling top start to this. I don't know if I'm gonna do the whole top that way or not, but I'm at least using that concept for how to start it. So if you're looking to do this, then you know where to head to see how to do it. It is the Cinnamon Stitches Spring Fling tutorial, and I will link that down in the description box below. But basically, you start out by making a square, sort of, and this is gonna be where your head hole goes. And you kind of wear it like this. It's got like a little bit of a boxy kind of neck to it. And the reason I decided to make this was I opened that yarn from Cynthia and I was really inspired to use this yarn, which at the time it didn't have a ball band on it. And I was saying I was pretty sure it was a sweet roll. I did look this up and it is the birthday cake colorway of sweet roll. So if you are interested in this yarn, that is what this yarn is. I love it. I think it's so pretty. It's like really pretty pastels, pinks and purples and blues and just like gorgeousness. I was inspired by this. I really wanted to use this. At first, I was like, maybe I'll make a hat. And then I was like, no, I really want to make a top, but I only have one, which is definitely not enough to make a top, especially in my size. So I was like, okay. Well, let's see if I can figure out what the yarn is. Well, I found the yarn online and it is the birthday cake one, but it's also discontinued and I don't have money to buy that right now anyways. So I had another idea, which was to look through my other yarns and come up with some ideas of yarns that would coordinate. So I took some clips and I will insert those here. So this is the birthday cake colorway of Sweet Roll, and that's what I'm currently using to start this top. This is actually discontinued, but it is like readily available online, so I might be able to get more of it. But I'm also contemplating mixing other colors into this top, and rather than using this whole cake and then switching to other yarns where it would be kind of a jarring change, I'm thinking about mixing other yarns in like as I go, you know, switching periodically. So, I went and gathered some yarns that I think kind of match the vibe of this color, which I really love this. This is like so nice. But I do have some thinner ones. So, this is a two weight. This is a three weight. This is a one weight. This is a three weight. So, these are some different color options that I have. And obviously, I will have to double or triple strand depending on which ones I use. But I was thinking these outer colors of this one match really well. And then same with this one, like the purple, the cream, and this like lighter pink match really well. I think this matches really well as like a double stranding color. Like this whole cake would probably be able to go in pretty well. And then this one, basically from this sort of light purple color and out, I think would match pretty well, especially these two shades. But I could also, I'm very early on in this project, I could introduce blue.
Because there is blue in three of these cakes I'm considering adding into it. So it doesn't really matter if there's blue in this cake as long as I'm putting blue in from the other cakes.
So I actually realized that these two yarns are both two-weight yarns. I originally thought the one was a one-weight. And this is just something that you always have to look for when you're picking yarns based on weights.
So right now I'm double stranding these together and caking them up, working on untangling this little bit of yarn barf. But these two colors go really well together, I feel like, and match the shirt nicely. So this is what I was saying, is these two colors are, or these two yarns are technically the same. These were both classified as a 2. So I thought that this thinner one was a 1, but apparently, according to the ball band, it's a 2. It is definitely not the same thickness, though. So something to keep in mind when you're, you know, picking out yarn thicknesses. Not all yarn, the same weight yarn is created alike.
So far, I decided to double strand together those two ice yarns, and I haven't messed with the other ones yet, but I have plenty more of this really thin ice yarn that I can double strand with some of the other ones that I think will make it match really nicely too. So I feel like I will have no problem coming up with the yarn that I need to make the whole top, and I think it will kind of grow and change as the top goes on.
So that is what I did. I made some cakes. This one's kind of looking a little on the floppy side. I've used a little bit of it, but here's what it looks like. I think it is so beautiful. And it was funny because I actually ended up using two different ice yarns for this, which I didn't even realize when I was putting them together. One of them was this ice yarns, the Cakes Baby Fine is the name of it. I don't know if it has a colorway or not, but it is a two-weight yarn. And this is actually what I was talking about like, you know, weights of yarn being kind of hit or miss, like not being the same. This one is the Cakes Rainbow. And they were both two weights of yarn. Did I show that? They are both considered a two-weight. So these are both considered a two-weight, and then I believe one of the clips I took I showed, but I will show you again. Dropping my yarn bands. I will show you guys again what I was talking about, but like these are both considered the same weight of yarn, which is absolutely not true. These are not the same weight of yarn, but they were both marked as a 2. Isn't that crazy? So anyway, about it though, they went together beautifully. And together, they meet up nicely with the four-weight yarn that I'm using for my other cake. So I've got this cake, and I think that together these colors really make it match this cake. Whereas on their own, these colors would have not been like as matchy, but put together, that thinner strand with that thicker color, that was like a more bright colors, I think it really matches super well. So what I'm doing was, I decided that I wouldn't just like use up this whole cake and then switch to other cakes because I'm so sorry, because that would look pretty disjointed. Like it would look like I ran out of yarn. It would look like I ran out of yarn and then just switched to like a different yarn, you know? I wanted it to look like not mismatchy, but like, I don't know, kind of scrappy, but like also matchy and like purposeful. So what I did was I'm alternating. I did some rows in the sweet roll, and then I'm doing some rows. I did some rows from here down to here in the ice yarns that I have doubled up together. And then now I switched back to the sweet roll, and I think it is working out perfectly. It works with the like self-striping that the sweet roll has, since this is also a self-striping yarn. And then it just like, it makes the variegation, I guess, or the striping, I guess, look natural. It doesn't look like jarring. So this first part, the second color that's like held double into there was like a light pink. But as it goes on, it turns into this kind of brownish pink. So what I did was I purposely waited until it started to get lighter again, and then I switched back to my color, to my sweet roll, because I didn't want to switch. I was actually originally going to do, I think it was like the same amount of rows, like I was going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, ignoring these because these were like my starting stuff. These were my double crochet rounds, was 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I was going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. But that would have had me ending on this dark color, and then I would have went to this purple, and it would have been jarring. And I wanted the transition to seem natural, like you're fading into the color. Oops. Let me mute that. There we go. Anyway, so sorry, I got distracted by that. I wanted it to seem natural. So I waited till it transitioned into the lighter shade for that double strand, and then I brought my other color back in. And I'm going to make sure I keep doing that, to make sure that, sorry, I'm getting messages and it's distracting me, to make sure that my transitions look seamless. But yeah, so that is what my top is looking like. I think it's looking so cute. It'll probably take me a minute to make this because I'm kind of slow at wearables. Yeah, my attention span is not very great for these types of projects, but anything where I'm just like doing a double crochet over and over, sometimes I struggle with it. Once I start getting into it where there's like a lot more double crochets to do in a row, I lose my attention when I'm trying to work on it. So it'll probably be a hot minute before I'm done with it, but I wanted to update you guys and show you what I had been working on. Let me know down in the comments what you guys are working on, and I will see you guys again real soon. Sometime soon, I want to do a community spotlight. I've got a lot of emails for community spotlight. It was just with the hurricane and everything going on. And then honestly, I just haven't been in the headspace to do it. I've kind of been like procrastinating on it a little bit, but I will be doing one sometime soon. So feel free if you are wanting to send in makes for Community Spotlight. If you already know the jazz of what Community Spotlight is and all that, you can feel free to send those in. And sometime soon, I will get into my email and get all of those out and put together probably a fairly large Community Spotlight video. Anyways, guys, I hope you are doing good. I really, really do. Please let me know what you are up to in the comments if you would like to. And I will see you guys on the next video. Bye, guys.